Hello, guten Tag, and welcome back to another YouTube video. In today's video, I want to explain how white balance works, and after we understood how it works, how we can manipulate it to our liking to really enhance our filmmaking and all of our cinematic scenes. The following video is a lesson from my online course, Interview Masterclass, where I teach how to capture high quality interviews. From lighting for storytelling to capturing really crisp audio, understanding compositions and angles and how they can affect the mood that you want to portray, different styles of interviews, etc., etc. The course launched almost a week ago, but the launch week is 25% off, so today and tomorrow is your last chance to get that discount. So if you're interested, there's a link down in the description below. But now let's talk about white balance. White balance is a really complex topic, but mastering and understanding white balance can give you a lot of options on set to enhance your scene. Our eyes immediately adjust to our surroundings and they perform an auto white balance. Even though some of our cameras do have auto white balance, they're not nearly as good as our human eyes. And I would also stay away from automatic white balance on any of my cameras when shooting interviews. Sunlight usually sits around 5600 Kelvin in color temperature, whereas a tungsten light or a fire sits around 3000 Kelvin. When looking at fire, for example, we can immediately tell that it's way warmer than sunlight. Our camera can't make this distinction on its own, so we need to tell it what it's looking at. The white balance point of color temperature is basically telling our camera what's neutral white. So if I'm being illuminated by a light source that is set to 5600 Kelvin, and I'm setting the white balance on my camera to 5600 Kelvin, they match, and now my light is pretty neutral white. If our camera is set to 5600 Kelvin and our subject is illuminated via a light source that is set to 3200 Kelvin, the entire image will be way warmer. But if we set our camera to 3200 Kelvin now, it will look exactly the same as it was when our camera was set to 5600 Kelvin and our light source was 5600 Kelvin as well. And if we understand this concept, we can actually play around with it. So if we only have a light source that is 5600 Kelvin, like the sun coming in, for example, we can set the white balance on our camera to a lower number, and then the natural sunlight coming in will appear a lot cooler than it actually is. Whereas if we raise the color temperature inside of our camera, our scene will look a lot warmer than it actually is. On interview setups, I usually set the white balance on my cameras to the dominant light temperature in the room that I can't control. In a setting like this, this is usually around 5600 Kelvin because this is the dominant light temperature that is coming in through our big windows from the outside. If you're not 100% sure what the light temperature in your room is, there's an app for it and it's called Light Spectrum Pro, and you can point it at any source in the room and it will tell you roughly what the white balance actually is and you can act accordingly. You can also use the auto white balance tool inside of your camera just to get a feel for what the white balance is and then set your cameras accordingly too. Once we set our white balance, we can now adjust our own lights. And this is where bicolor lights come in really handy. For example, if we set the color temperature in our cameras to 4000 because the dominant light source is around 4000 Kelvin, we can take our key light source to illuminate our subject and also set it to around 4000 Kelvin to match the ambient color temperature. If you have different cameras and you want to match them in post, you can also use a custom white balance feature that most of modern cameras have. This way, you point the camera at your subject and let it do a custom white balance, and you do this on all of your cameras, and then they will roughly match better in post. If you shoot a lot of interviews throughout your career, you'll often find yourself in an office building, and most of them actually have fluorescent lights mounted to the ceilings. They are around 5600 Kelvin daylight balanced. But since those are not lights made for filmmaking, but just to illuminate an office building, they're not 100% accurate, and oftentimes they have a slight either green or magenta shift. I already mentioned this in the lighting equipment section. Some of modern lights have something that's called a GM function, meaning green magenta shift. If your key light now only has the option to go to 5600 Kelvin, you will see a slight difference in the way that your subject is illuminated to the background, because the background will have either a green or a magenta shift. But if your key light has the option to perform a green magenta shift, you can then act accordingly and match the tint on your light source to the one in the room. I hope you liked my tutorial on how to use white balance, and if you did, then please give this video a thumbs up because it really helps the channel grow. Subscribe for more, I would really appreciate it, and there will be a lot more really cool behind the scenes as well as cinematography and lighting breakdowns. So I hope to see you on our next one.